Hi, in this video we will deal with a problem that occurs when you import shapes to 3D Studio Max, let's say from AutoCAD. And in this AutoCAD file that you see here, we have a few rectangles. Some of them are parallel to the home grid and two of them are perpendicular, and they are all on the same layer. So let's import those shapes. I'm gonna reset the scene here and I'm gonna import the shapes. Okay, by default you have this option for import. So if you have this option or this option, in both cases shapes that are on the same layer will be imported as one object. I'm gonna click OK. I'll W to maximize my viewport, and if I click on any of these rectangles, as you can see they are all selected. They are all one object and they have the name of their layer. So let's try to extrude and see what happens. As you can see, the rectangles that are parallel to the home grid, they extrude in the correct direction, but not these two. So we have problem here. Now I'm not gonna go into details about why this it's happening. I'm gonna do another video to explain the relation between the modifier stack and the transform engine inside 3D Studio Max. I will try to explain the, let's say, the under the hood thing that can explain things like this and other phenomenon in 3D Studio Max. But here in this video I'm gonna concentrate on trying to fix this problem. So first let's say that I'm gonna reset. I'm gonna import again. If I choose entity, what this does is every single object in AutoCAD, every single independent object will come in as a separate object. I'm gonna click OK. As you can see here, I have six separate objects. I have six objects. In this case I will not have any problem with extrusion. If I choose this one, go to modify panel and choose extrude, the extrusion will work well. It will go in the correct direction. But let's say that you don't want your scene to be filled with lots of shapes. Let's say you are importing like walls and you want to be able to extrude them not like this, you know, you don't want to click on each one of them and apply the extrude modifier. You just want to extrude them all at the same time as one object, but you want to fix the few problematic shapes that you have. So we will reset again, import. I will choose one of those two, doesn't matter. Okay, now they are all a single object. The first approach to this, I go to the sub-object level, choose spline, click on this one, then go down until I see this button detach. What this does, it will detach this rectangle from this object and create and make it as a single object. So I click detach, I can give it a name, whatever, rect 1. Now to be able to select this object, I need to get out from the sub object level by clicking on the top level, the object level. Then I will select this one, this object, the rect 1. Now what I can do, I have two possibilities. I can go to the spline sub object level, choose it, click rotate, and I will also choose angle snap so I can rotate in a fixed increment without decimal. So I will rotate it to 90 degrees. I can look here to see. Okay, now I get out from the sub-object level. I apply the extrude modifier, and as you can see, the extrusion now works in the correct direction. Of course, I can rotate it back. I can rotate it back to 90 degrees if I wanted to extrude in this direction. Now the problem, as you can see, the pivot point of this rectangle is the same as the object that it was part of it. So if I want the pivot point to be somewhere here in the middle of this rectangle, because as you can see now, if I want to rotate this rectangle, it will rotate starting from this point. So I go to hierarchy, affect pivot only. I can choose, let's say, center to object. I turn off affect pivot only. Now I can rotate it back, and now my extrusion works well. Now a second approach, now I will apply it to this problematic rectangle here. I go to the spline sub object level, I choose this one, I detach it also, the same thing I did for this one. Detach, rect 2. Also, if I will move the pivot point here to the center of this rectangle, so I can rotate it easily, not starting from this point. As you can see, I go to hierarchy, affect pivot only, center to object. Okay, now what I can do is I will rotate it by 90 degrees. I go to utility panel, click on reset X form, then reset selected. If I go to modify panel, as you can see, there is an X form modifier applied to the spline. Now I can keep it like this and start to add my modifiers on top, like say extrude, and as you can see now the extrusion also works correctly. It is going in the correct direction. I'm gonna delete the extrude. What you can do also, if you don't want to have this modifier, you can right click and say convert to editable spline, and what this does, it will bake the information of the X4 modifier into the geometry. So now I can I will add the extrude modifier, and it's all fixed. So I hope this video was useful, and thank you for watching.